Amen. Miss Fowler must be thinking about me today, because I've got some news I want to share. First of all, welcome to Bowman Church of God. Glad to have everybody here. Miss Fowler, you say, you got your shouting shoes on? You got your shouting shoes on? If you don't, I hope this encourages you. At jail today, we had 18 men come out. Out of 18 men, 18 men stood up and come to the front of the cell and accepted Christ into their life. You know, and as they came up to the front of the cell, I thought to myself, how courageous are they? We're in this beautiful church. We've got air. We hear the word. We have good praise and worship music. When altar call comes, everybody looks at their feet. It's like we're ashamed to come to the altar. And those men came up to the front, and they're in jail. Came up to the front and was proud to stand there, proud to be in front of everybody. And as one would come, another came. And then all of a sudden, everybody jumped up and came. You know, maybe that's what we need to do. Stop being ashamed. Stop being scared if somebody's looking at you. If somebody is thinking about, have you backslid? What you going through? What have you done? Stop worried about that. You know, it just washed over me today, and I thank God that I got to witness it. We're going to go ahead and take up our tithes and offering. Just let the Lord lead you. Lord, we thank you. We thank you for this day, God. Lord, I thank you for all that you do in my life, God. And I thank you for our church, Lord Jesus. Lord, I thank you, God, for the people that's here. And I thank you for the ones that's coming. Lord, I thank you for everybody here that's able to give, Lord Jesus. And I pray, God, that you bless the ones that's not, God, that they're able to give next time. Lord, I thank you and I praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Now put your shouting shoes on.
Some of these days I'm going home.
Trouble.
kindred and friends now wait for me. If we could just walk around and shake some hands and smile at each other and tell each other we love each other, give a little hug. Amen. Everybody just stared at me now.
He said, just don't cough on them.
The more I trust him, the more I love him. Nothing good for me here and now. The longer I know him, the better I can show him. Richer, deeper, fuller.
the depart, oh, it gets sweeter.
As the days go by,
as the days go by, it gets sweeter.
Everybody here tonight, and I just want to remind us to just keep our minds focused on the Lord and just give Him praise and just worship Him. We always say this, but you know, we're few in number, sometimes we get a little, you know, we just kind of want to sit back. But let's just remember that we're here to focus on the Lord and just to get a blessing and be a blessing to one another. Amen.
You hold my every moment. You calm my rage and sea. You walk with me through fire and heal all my disease. I trust in you.
What are we willing to do to be in His presence? I know we've come out, we've gotten our car, we drove down the road, you know, first you had to wake up for your nap probably. But, you know, honestly, that's the name of this song. Honestly, what would you do? This song says, I'll go down 7 times, a tree I'll even climb, I'll even tear the roof off just to get to you. What are we willing to do? Amen. Think about it. What are we willing to do? We have it so easy. Amen. We do. No matter how hard we feel and how miserable we feel sometimes, we do. We have it easy. So let's just think about that tonight. Honestly, be honest with yourself and think about what would you do for Christ this evening.
There's no use trying to hide it from your eyes. There's no need in wearing a disguise. For you see in me a light of Pharisee. I'm trying to be as honest as I can. And I'm trying to hide it from your eyes. There's no need in wearing a disguise. For you see in me a lot of Pharisee. Now I'm trying to be as honest as I can. And I'm going to
time. Father, we thank you tonight, God, for all your many blessings. And God, I pray that that is everyone's heart. God, those watching by Facebook, those among us tonight, that God, we want to serve you honestly. And I believe that's the intent of everyone here, God. That's why they're here, to lift up the name of Jesus and to learn more about you. And Father, I just pray that tonight you would give us wisdom and knowledge, encourage us, strengthen us, and empower us, God, by your word. And we just give you the honor, the glory, and the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. If you got your Bibles, turn with me tonight to Isaiah chapter 40. And we're going to read a few verses of scripture. And I'm going to, again, this tonight, I'm going to use the New Living Translation. And I used to would not use other translations, to be honest with you. But I like the way that a lot of them break it down, in a really to our understanding. But if you have a King James, just feel free to follow along. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 21. It says, haven't you heard? Don't you understand? Are you deaf to the words of God? The words he gave before the world began? Are you so ignorant? God sits above the circle of the earth. The people below seem like grasshoppers to him. He spreads out the heavens like a curtain and makes his tent from them. He judges the great people of the world and brings them all to nothing. They hardly get started, barely taking root when he blows on them and they wither. The wind carries them off like a chaff. To whom will you compare me? Who is my equal? Asked the Holy One. Look up to the heavens. Who created all the stars? He brings them out like an army, one after another, calling each by its name. Because of his great power and incomparable strength, not a single one is missing. O Jacob, how can you say the Lord does not see your troubles? O Israel, how can you say God ignores your rights? Have you never heard? Have you never understood? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of all the earth. He never grows weak or weary. No one can measure the depths of his understanding. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Even youth will become weak and tired, and young men will fall in exhaustion. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Father, we thank you for the reading of your word. I pray for the next few minutes, may you anoint me to preach your word. And Father, I give you the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. I've actually been studying over this particular passage of scripture for several weeks now, just meditating on it, and I begin to feel like it's time that God wants to encourage someone tonight, because as I shared with you recently, and all the things that I've been trying to seek the Lord in, it just seems like he keeps bringing a comparison of an eagle, and he talks about how the freedom and the liberty of the eagle is, and how they can soar above the storms and all that. And so it seems like everywhere I turn lately, I run into some kind of something that leads me back to this scripture. And so tonight, I really want to try to help all of us come to that place to build our faith, because it's so easy to get to a place of discouragement, a place of disheartenment, to get tired and just weary. But tonight, God wants to strengthen us. So I hope that tonight you'll take this word and just apply it to your life and let God minister. So as we go back at verse 26, I want to say, it says, look up to the heavens. Who created all the stars? He who brings them out like an army, one after another, calling each by his name. Because of his great power and incomparable strength, not a single one is missing. Now begin to think about that. I don't know about you, but a lot of times at night I like to go out and see the stars when I am awake. It's not often, but if I am awake when the stars are out, I like to go out, because there's something, it's always just been a peace about going out and seeing the moon and the stars, because I've always felt, when I just felt so alone and felt so just burdened, there was some way, somehow I'd go out and I'd look up at the stars, and even though I couldn't understand it, I always would find a peace. Because, and looking back at this scripture, I believe it was God in his spirit just reminded me every time I looked up at the stars, it was his spirit saying, look at the stars. You can't know, you can't count them. They're just so many to be counted. He said, but yet I know them all by name. I want you to think about that. Your God, your creator, your father, he calls them all by name. I mean, there is just countless. I don't know about you. I can't even begin to count the stars. But I look up and I see the beauty that it all is around, that is all around us. And yet, How is it that I struggle? It's because I lose sight of who my Father is. And that's what I want to encourage you tonight. Because God's not, it's not His will for you to be discouraged tonight. But you have got to get back and remind yourself. We've got to get to the place where I talked about this morning, where we've got to get self-control. And what I mean by self-control is when things rise up against us, it's time that we stop yielding to those moments of weakness and yielding to those aggravations, and begin to stand up and be the mighty man and woman of God of who you really are. Let that spirit man rise up and a woman rise up inside of you tonight. Begin to stand up and proclaim. Let your, when the storms come in, begin to remind the enemy, as many as the stars are that I can't even count. He knows them by name. That's you got to remind yourself. You got to begin to build yourself. What did David say? It said David encouraged himself in the Lord. I've said it many times. We see David in the same battle with everybody else. But yet, you see, we all together until the heat gets, when the heat really gets on us, then we want to find that blame. That's just the natural instinct of the human to find a blame, whether it be a person, whether it be a situation. We're constantly wanting to cast blame somewhere when God's saying, I want you to just look at yourself. And remind yourself tonight, don't cast blame, but begin to remind yourself of who your Father is. Begin to remind yourself of who you are. You are a mighty man and woman of God. We were called to be warriors. I told Sister Lisa, I think years ago when I first met her, I told her, you've got a warrior spirit. I said, and what that means is that's why so many times when you want to give up, you get mad at yourself because you can't give up. It's because that warrior spirit, God has called you to be a warrior. And I believe that many of us are called to be warriors tonight. It's time that we begin to take up the whole armor of God and place it on us. Listen, everything that I'm telling you, I've been talking, I just questioning the Lord and talking to Him. And I'm like, Lord, really, what else is there to preach? We've preached from Genesis to Revelation. We've preached it frontwards, backwards, up, down. We preached it all that we know how to preach it. I said, God, what? He said, stop preaching it and start living it. Stop trying to make it harder than what it is, and just simply start believing that I love you. Believe that I am the Father and your Creator. Believe that I formed you in your mother's womb, that I knew you, I had a plan before you, way before you even was created. He said, and even though you altered off of that, I knew you was going to do that, so I sent my Son. And so my Son came so He could die for you. And I knew that even then you was going to be stubborn, so I sent the Holy Spirit to dwell inside of you. And I knew even then you was going to be stubborn, so that's why I sent the preacher. Amen. And even though that you're still stubborn, you just got a stubborn preacher. we're just at a stand. We got a show off now. Amen. So now I got my gun drawn, you got yours. We're just going to have to stand off. Because I'm at a place where I just want to tell you something. You don't need to know nothing else. You need to operate in what you already know. That's what you need tonight. You need to understand. That's why I feel like God gave me this scripture. Because He said it's time for you to soar up on wings like eagles. It's time for you to mount up on your wings and stop growing weary and just soar above every circumstance. How do I do that, Pastor? You go back and begin to dig up what you already know. Start operating in the things that you already know. I've told you, many of you could probably quote the Bible better than I can. You don't need a man to stir you up. You need to just begin to stir up the gift that's inside of you. You got to begin to trust that your God is a God that has called the stars by name. He is such a God. He said, how can you even compare me to anybody else or anything else? How can you even question me, is what He was asking. He said, how can you question me? And knowing in my superiority, knowing how great of a God I am, how can you even consider questioning me? But because you did, let me remind you of who I am. Let me just give you a few of my accolades, whatever you call them things. He says, look up into the heavens and count the stars and realize He that brings them out, He brings them out like an army, one after another, calling each by His name. See, God doesn't just fling them out there. He said he it's like an army. I begin to think about that. It's a reminder. When we look up at the stars, God's trying to remind you you're not alone. Not only is he will never leave you nor forsake you, but even I believe that beyond that, He's reminding you that there are those that are gone before you. We're surrounded by such a greater cloud of witness. You know, we get so distracted on the naysayers, and we get so focused on the one or two that speaks and discourages us. Why don't we start looking back and reminding us and start encouraging ourselves of our brothers and sisters? Well, who's that, Pastor? our brother Moses, and how he stood before the burning bush, and he took the Ten Commandments, and he went down, and he went and he destroyed them because they was even bowing before a false god. But guess what? God was angry. But God had mercy. Thank God he didn't end us there. He went on. We know the story of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. We can just go on through history. And for lack of sake of time tonight, I'm not going to do that. But I want you to remind yourself, you were surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses. Look at the mighty men and women of God that went on before us. They're still praying for us, church. Pastor Suttle, brother and sister Fowler. We've got some great, mighty men and women of God that have went on before us. And listen, they're cheering us on. I really believe it. And it may not be, but I feel like they're cheering us on. And they're saying, don't give up. You're just one prayer away. You're just one step away. See, the enemy's wanting you to give up right before you get to that victory line. But listen, church, stop letting the weariness weigh you down. Begin to shake it off. And again, don't look for me. Don't look for anybody else. But begin to look within yourself and call yourself out. Say, no, I remember the night that I bowed and I repented of my sins. That person died that night. And yes, that old man's trying to rise back up, but you are a dead man. I curse you in the name of Jesus. And you begin to resurrect that person of peace, that person of joy, that person of laughter, because that's who you really are. That's the Spirit of God inside of you. Stop pushing that person down and letting the old man live. But tonight, begin to stir up the gift of God inside of you. How do I do that? Remind yourself of who he is. It says, because of his great power and incomparable strength, not a single one is missing. Not one star is out of place. And I'm not one that gets into astronomy and all that, but the universe is amazing. The galaxy is amazing. And if you look at that kind of stuff, it is just mind-blowing. And we, our scientists, well, we think we really catching up. Well, and the whole time God's sitting there, when we discover something, God's just laughing and said, well, I knew that the whole time. I could have told you that. I created it. But we don't want to receive. We want something or someone to blame. We don't want someone to trust. Because that's a part of ourselves that we will have to unlock, that we have secured behind walls for so long. We got to become that person that we trust the Lord's way and not ours, church. And what I mean by that, I'm telling you, he can give you such a peace that it will not bother you. Other people, the concerns of other people, and there is such a peace that he will get you to a place. Not out of, I don't care what people think, because that's what we do. We go from one extreme to the other. We go from caring too much to, I don't care. No, we got to walk in the balance of Christ. That's what I'm saying. That's why so many church people are miserable, because, again, you can get religious, and we do that, even without realizing it. And religion is simply getting in the routine of something and taking, you know, can I really blow your mind? If we want to be technical, the Bible says, take not the Lord God thy name in vain. That really ain't talking about using the GD word. He's talking about using his name without value, without power. He's talking about your father without the purity of who he is. And can I tell you something? We do it almost every time we come together. Because when we praise that name of Jesus and we start saying, knowing the whole time in our heart, we're not going to give it to him. Can I tell you, that's when we're taking the Lord's name in vain. We miss the mark because we label sin. Sin is not a label. Sin is a spirit. It's spirit warfare. That's what we got to understand. And how we interact with one another makes a difference. Church, you are mighty men and women of God. You need to understand tonight that you have the power of God inside of you. You have the ability to speak to the mountain and it be moved. You say, well, I've spoken, it ain't moved. But how many of you really want to say behind that, but I knew it wouldn't? Because really, if we'll be honest, all I'm asking you tonight is be honest with who you are. Be honest with who God, people's asked me, how do you do what you're experiencing? I'm just being honest. I have stopped lying to myself every day I get up, thinking I'm something that I'm not. I wake up every day realizing that this is a new day, that yesterday is gone. I can't ride on yesterday's anointing. Today, I have to walk in a newness. Are you following me? The only way I can do that is because every day I wake up and I say, God, you're the one that calls the stars by name. You've got them in an order. You've got them as a mighty army, as your word says. And it goes on. Oh, he keeps wanting to turn the page. You may want to read something else. In verse 28, he said, have you heard? Have you never understood? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of all the earth. He never grows weak or weary. No one can measure the depths of his understanding. He gives power to the weak and strength to the powerless. Even youth will become weak and tired, and young men will faint in exhaustion. So it pretty much labels all of us. He said we're all going to get tired. We're all going to get exhausted if we do this without him. But what he's trying to tell you, he said he's the everlasting Father. He's the creator of all earth. And I know that you know this, but do you really know? You remember several Wednesday nights ago I asked you if you hear what I'm saying? I'm asking you tonight, do you really hear what I'm trying to say? That's why, as much as when God gives me these messages, man, I'm so excited and I can see fire preaching it. But when I get behind the pulpit, he shuts all that down. And I believe the reason is because, like I've told you before, God wants us to grow. He don't want us to get caught up in just excitement, because we miss the mark when we fail to listen with ears to hear. How many times have we come and the preacher spoke, but because of our... what's the word I'm looking for? It's your intent, what you come in with. How do you perceive it is what you're going to receive, even tonight. You're either going to receive good of the flesh, of the spirit, or you're going to receive frustration of the flesh. And many of you know what I'm talking about. That's why I'm at a place where I just want to call out that we have let hide in the dark for so long. It's time that we stand face to face in the mirror and realize that God wants to mount us up on wings as eagles. I'm going to say it like this, and then if the musicians want to go ahead and play something softly. I know we ain't got no piano player. But I want to ask you tonight, because the generation behind us, what are we passing to them? I want to pass the torch of power, of anointing, of authority. I want the men and women, the children, to raise up realizing they are mighty men and women of God. Not when they get older, now. They're mighty men and women of God. We need to start speaking these things, but we need to believe it when we speak it. That's what I'm talking about. We're living a lie, church, when we speak the things of God, but we don't live. And when I say that, you're only selling yourself short. So tonight, if God spoke to you at any time, I want you to understand, you need to let the devil know tonight and tell yourself, never again question who you are. Because I have found what he means, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. God will never give up on you. He's going to fight for you all the way to the end. Even if you give up on him, he won't give up on you. So you might as well stop being miserable and just get on the train of obedience and blessings. Let him give you strength. Let him give you peace. Let him give you joy. Because we can't minister, church, when people see our hardship instead of the blessings of God. And you can't mount up on wings as eagle until you understand who your Father is. Do you not understand who you are? You're a child of God. So tonight, take your rightful place. Step in authority. It don't matter how you feel. It ain't you anyway. It's God giving you authority. That's what you got to understand. It ain't you. It's not me. It's Christ. So tonight, step up. Stop letting intimidation, fear, anxiety, worry, stress, envy, strife. Stop letting these things control you. You're a child of God. Mount up on wings as eagles and you soar tonight. Get the strength. Let him carry you. He wants to carry you tonight. He loves you. Father, we thank you for your word. Lord, I've done my best to obey you, and I ask God that if there's anyone here that this spoke to, if it did, God, let them, Lord, get victory tonight. Don't let them waste another second. Those watching by Facebook, Lord, right where they're at, they don't have to be in the same environment we're in. It makes it easier, but God, you're right where they're at. And if they'll just call on the name of the Lord right where they're at, you'll meet them. But Lord, for those of us that are here tonight, we have the ability and the honor and the privilege to be able to lay hands on one another and stand in agreement. For the Bible says where two or three agree as a touching anything, ask and it shall be given. Lord, let us start asking in faith once again. Let us remind ourselves of who you are and whose we are. Tonight, let us just surrender all to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. These altars are open.